Hey there, Nation, and welcome to the show where we help you to play miniatures wargaming on a budget. It is I, Commander Cheapskate, and we are back with another episode of Cheap Shots, and this is Cheap Shot number 75. And on this episode, we're going to show you guys how to quickly as well as cheaply paint some Death Rattle Skeleton Warriors for your games of Warhammer Age of Sigmar, or Skeleton Warriors, or Whites, or Graveguard for Warhammer Fantasy. So as you can see here, this is what the end result's going to look like with your guys' unit using our Cheapskate method. In the end, assuming that you're purchasing everything for the very first time using our Cheapskate method, it's going to cost you a grand total investment of $9.87. Now, when you compare that to the same materials you need to purchase from Citadel as well as Army Painter, Army Painter and Citadel is going to cost you $112.66, with a grand total difference in savings of $102 as well as 79 cents on that one. So because of that, as you can see, this is a beautiful tabletop standard for your miniatures. We're going for a very ethereal type of paint job going on with these skeleton warriors to make them look like that they're ghosts and they're picking up spare bits of rusted metal in order to do combat in the realms or in the old world, depending on how you want to use these guys. You could also use this as well for Mantic Games King of War if you wanted to as well. So that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's get this tutorial on a roll to show you guys how to quickly and more importantly cheaply paint up some skeleton warriors. All right, so the first thing you have to do, of course, is to assemble your miniatures as well as prime, as well as put texturing on the bases. Now, for the cheapskate myth on this one, it's going to cost us $3.99, and the reason why is because we're buying some Rust-Oleum white primer in order to spray paint in order to prime our miniatures. The texturing on this one is done with sand and wood glue. All I do is I apply a layer of wood glue on the bases, dust them with some sand that I get outside, and wait for it to dry. And once it dries, I then can make a mixture of half and half of water and wood glue, and then I put it over the entirety of the texture to act as a wash in order to seal it as well. So like I said, the $3.99 that we're paying for is actually for the Rust-Oleum, the water, wood glue, as well as sand are just items I have lying around my house. Now, assuming you're going to do exactly the same thing from Citadel as well as Army Painter, you need to buy a pot of Astrogranite for $7.80, which is a textured paint used by Games Workshop, as well as Corax White Spray for that's going to do the priming, which costs you $17. Now, when you combine those two together, you're talking about a grand total of $24.80, which means that so far we are saving you $20.81 since at this point. And we should just let you guys right now, we haven't even started putting paint yet, and already if you were to use the Citadel as well as Army Painter products, you've blown right past our cheapskate method right off the bat, because the cheapskate method is actually $9.87 in total. So we haven't even started painting yet with Games Workshop products, and we're already saving you guys a ton of money. So for our next step, what we're gonna do is what we're gonna use is what's called glazing. Since we're doing an ethereal style paint job on these miniature, we're gonna use glazing techniques to do that. In order to do this, we're gonna use two colors. We're gonna use Skyline by Folk Art. That costs you 75 cents at your local Hobby Lobby, as well as Deltum Serum Coat. We're using Tahitian Blue, which costs 65 cents at your local Hobby Lobby as well. And now, if you're wondering what glazing is nothing more than when you just take paint as well as water and you mix them together. What you're gonna do is go for about a 50-50 mix of paint as well as water, and when you mix these two substances together, it's gonna have about the consistency of milk is what it's gonna look like when you get done mixing these paints. Glazing is nothing more than just applying layers of watered down paint on top of a white prime surface. This does a couple of things. The first thing that ends up happening is that the colors will go directly into the recesses of the miniature, and at the same time leaving the white undercoat showing through the top to create this idea of kind of like a wash, all right, where the darker color goes to the recesses and the white surfaces above just get highlighted a little bit by the coloring on this one. Now, I will tell you this, glazing is very, very easy to do. However, it is extremely boring process. You have to put about 5 to 6 layers of glazing on this. But at the same time, though, when you compare this to items you need to buy from Games Workshop, it's extremely cheap. From Games Workshop, you need to buy Nighthaunt Gloom as well as Nihilac Oxide. Nihilac Gloom costs $7.80 and Nihilac Oxide $4.55. And right off the bat, we are cheapskate method is at $5.14 as opposed to Games Workshop $37.15, and we're saving you $32.01. At this point. So once you guys put the glazing on, once you're done with that, move on to your guys' next step, which is a dry brush as well as a wash. Alright, so for this next step, we're going to use what's called we're going to do a dry brush as well as a wash at this stage. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to use Pale Gray by Folk Art, costs you 75 cents, as well as Bright Blue by Attleboro Paint, which costs you 50 cents. You can get both of these at your local Walmart, and our cheapskate method now is costs you $6.29. All you're going to do real quick is to dry brush your miniatures with the light pale gray that you've already glazed before, so that white paint catches onto the raised surfaces while leaving that glazing in the recesses of the miniature. Now, the reason why we're doing this highlighting real quick and dry dry brushing it, so that way when we slap on our blue wash on top of our miniatures, it's going to give us kind of like a nice little glowing look going on with our miniatures. In which case, all we do is we just take a pot of bright blue, once again, mix it with water, 50-50 consistency, and just apply it like a wash all over the place. And all you need to do is do it once. And what's going to happen is that bright blue is going to catch up on that white dry brushing that we did earlier and tint it just slightly to a bluish color, which is going to give you this beautiful ethereal look that's going on right now at your miniatures, as you can see right here. Now, if you were to go with the Citadel as well as Army Painter method, you'll need to buy a pot of Ulthuan Gray, which costs you $4.55, as well as Gulliman Blue, which is a glaze that costs you $14.92, and that brings your grand total so far to $56.62. And when you compare that with the Cheapskate method, we're saving you $50.33 at this point. So once we're done with that, next thing we do now is start painting all the metallics on these miniatures. Now I'm going to use what I like to call graveyard steel is what it is. I basically do a 50-50 mix. I take a 50-50 mix of gunmetal gray by Folk Art, which runs you 75 cents at your local Walmart, as well as Anita's acrylic bronze color metallic paint, which also costs 65 cents. What you do is you put those two together in a 50-50 mix, combined together, kind of creates this kind of rusty, kind of brownish steel color. I like to call it graveyard metal is what I like to call it. And all you gotta do, of course, is to base coat all the metallic elements in two thin layers of this. So things like the shields, the helmets, the armor, the weapons, that sort of thing. Now you might be wondering, Commander Cheapskate, why are you doing it that way with the metal? This look I want to give is like this ethereal look where the spirits are actually picking up like rusted weapons off the ground and attacking with it. And that kind of makes this kind of cool little effect going on as well. So all you gotta do, of course, is take that 50-50 mix of my graveyard metal and just apply it everywhere all over the miniatures that you want it to be metallic as well. Now, if you want to do exactly the same thing with Citadel Army Painter, you need to buy a pot of Lead Belcher as well as Warblock Bronze. Both these cost is $7.80 from your local gaming store or from Games Workshop, and that's going to bring your grand total to $72.22, while our Cheapskate method is at $7.62. Now, by using our Cheapskate method at this stage, we are actually saving you $64.60. Now the next step we're going to do, Cork, is a quick dry brush. We're going to do this on all the metallic elements that we just got done painting with our metallic metal, our graveyard metal that I created earlier. And the reason why that is the case is because we're going to wash these armor and metal panels later on, so the dry brush is really going to help create that difference and that illusion of depth on the miniature as well. Now in this case, we're going to dry brush with Anniversary Silver. You can find this at your local Hobby Lobby by Folk Art for 75 cents, and that's going to bring our Cheapskate method to $8.37. Now from GW and Army Painter, you need to buy a pot of Necron Compound, which runs you $4.55, and you're just going to do quick dry brushing, and your Games Workshop Army Painter methods cost you $76.77 at this point. Now when you subtract our two values, of course, the grand total savings is $68.40. Just do a quick dry brushing real quick. As you can see, it does a beautiful job of catching the raised surfaces of the armor as well as the weapons, while leaving that darker graveyard metal in the recesses of the miniature. So now that we're done with the dry brush, next step is going to be a wash. Now for the wash on this one, all we're going to do is use a pot of Burnt Umber by Apple Barrel Paint. You can find this stuff at your local Walmart, cost you 50 cents. All you're going to do is you're going to mix that with some water with a 50-50 mix in order to create a dark brown wash. And once you do that, you're going to take that wash, you're going to paint it all over the entirety of the metallic metal pieces that we've done earlier. And as you can see in this photo, it does a beautiful job of creating this really rusted, grimy, oily, dirty kind of metal look, which kind of contrasts nicely with the vibrancy of color that we have with our ethereal look for our skeleton warriors. Now, of course, you could buy a pot of Agrax Earthshade from Citadel. It's going to cost you $7.80, but that's going to increase your initial budget to $84.57. So at this stage, we are sending you $75.70 at this point. So now that we're done with our miniatures, the next thing we need to do now is to work on the bases. So whether you believe it or not, we're actually really, really done with all the miniatures. All we're doing now is base work on this point. Now in this case, I like to use Anita's Great Acrylic. I just paint it all over the texturing on the bases. I put two thin layers on it. That's what's going to cost us 65 cents at your local Hobby Lobby, and that brings our Cheapskate method to $9.37. Now if you want to do exactly the same thing with GW or Army Painter, you'll need to buy a pot of Slaanesh Gray, which costs you $4.55, and that brings your total to $89.12. And at this point, all we're doing is saving you $79.75 at this point. Once you're done, of course, doing the base coating for your bases, next thing you do, of course, is a quick dry brush. In this case, I once again go back to Pale Gray by Folk Art. Just do a quick dry brush on the textured surface of the miniatures on the bases, so that way it kind of creates this illusion of depth on the bases as well. It makes it look like it's really grimy, kind of stone type of look as well. So once we're done dry brushing the bases, next thing we do now is to add some flocking. Now for my flocking, I use homemade flock that Iron Major actually provides for me. It's made out of sawdust real quick. All I do is I just add some wood glue to the bases where I want the flocking to go. Just do a quick dusting with our free homemade flock, and because this doesn't incur any cost. However, if you want to do the same technique using Games Workshop or Army Painter products, you'll need to buy an Army Painter basing set, which runs you $18.99. And when you combine that with the list of things you'll need to buy from GW as well as Army Painter, you're talking about a grand total investment of $108.11 at this point. And we're still at our $937 price point with our cheapskate method, which means we're talking about a savings difference of $98.74. And once you let that flocking dry, next thing you do now is to point paint the rim of the bases. So for this next step, you need to paint the rim of the bases in two thin layers of English Ivy Green. You can get this at your local Walmart for 50 cents. And all I do real quick is just put two thin layers on the rim of the bases, and whether you believe it or not, we're actually all done with our miniatures at this point. Now, if you want to do exactly the same thing from GW and Army Painter, you need to buy a pot of Vulcan Green, which costs you $4.55, and that's going to give you a grand total of $112.66 from Citadel as well as Army Painter. And when you compare that to the cheapskate method of $9.87, we're talking about a grand total savings of $102 as well as 79 cents. And once again, this is the end result that we were talking about earlier that we showed you at the beginning of the slide. As you can see, we have a beautiful tabletop standard with our ethereal looking skeleton warriors with rusted graveyard metal, and it looks awesome ready to throw down on the tabletop for whatever undead army you wish to use these guys for as well. So, like I said before, pretty simple. Once again, we are assuming that you're purchasing everything for the very first time. And when you compare that, when you look at that, our cheapskate method costs $9.87. Games Workshop and Iron Painter will cost you $112.66 with a difference of $102.79, which you could actually use to buy several pieces of miniatures with that money. It's actually quite a significant amount of money. So if you're looking for a way to cheaply and quickly paint up your miniatures, I suggest you try our cheapskate method. It's very fast, very quick, at the same time has a beautiful standard as well. So that's good to do for this one, you guys. As always, please feel free to like, comment, and or subscribe. Your guys' input is invaluable to us as always. Also, check us out on Facebook, Instagram, as well as blogger.com for all the latest greatest hobby news related to this channel. That's good to do for this one, you guys. We'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out and stay classy.